Hey, girl. Hey. Hey, girl. Hey, what's your name?
There I got it. Go. I can do it myself.
I was that 18, 19-year-old that really had no intentions of joining the Army. I can tell you from that perspective, you know, what it's like. And what I realized after joining the Army, having
a ladder, work gloves, lawn bags or plastic garbage bags, a gutter scoop or trowel, a handled scrub brush, and a garden hose.
And remember, if you want to start with a good clean brush, you got to end with one too.
Need more expert advice? Stop by your local True Value hardware store and ask a hardwarian. True Value. Start right. Start here.
I'm looking at a spot on the target I want to engage. Nothing's going to move. Once the buzzer goes off, I'm going to cleanly grab the pistol and bring it up to my...
This video isn't just about dry fire or live fire or stage strategy. It isn't about any one of those things. It's about learning a process where you're willing to work and willing to apply yourself to get better.
Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Yeah, I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we don't.
That Benz Marina Del Rey coasting. She be Puerto Rican, they parade waving. Last month I helped her with the car payment. Young and we alive.
Either way, all that trust has done is cause trouble. The kind of trouble you don't need, Ray.
What's wrong with a little trouble? With you, it's worth it.
Oh, I'm...
Are we good?
Kill the light. Kill the light. I think it's Terry.
Just like that, dear.
The bald guy. Clint. He can't get anything right. He said it'd be so easy. Your daughter, the trust. You're not worth the money.
Just like this year.
My name is Captain Kenrick Forrester, and I'm a Special Forces officer. I've been in the Army for 14 years, and I am currently the aide-de-camp to the Commanding General for the United States Army Special Forces Command.
We were identified, you know, by presidential directive as the only group that can wear this green beret.
I think in the Army there's a lot of things you could do. And I can tell you from the perspective of I was that 18, 19-year-old that really had no intentions of joining the Army. I can tell you from that perspective, you know, what it's like. And what I realized after joining the Army, having spent a year in college, was that I got a challenge out of the Army that I don't think I get anywhere else. I mean, you know, every parent's concerned about, you know, I've raised my child to 18 years old, what now? And I think the Army, what the Army provides is that we still have that mentoring, that environment where, you know, you're gonna hand your child over to people who have made it their life's work to mentor and lead people. And those are the things that I look at as Army Strong. And at the end of the day, I am Army Strong. You know, my wife is Army Strong, we are Army Strong, and that's how we define it. I am Army Strong because I have that character and I have that belief and I have that value.
good paintbrush is an investment. Protect yours by following a few simple cleanup tips. Here are the supplies you'll need for the job: a wire brush or paintbrush comb, stir stick, paint thinner, 3 glass jars or containers, some clean rags, plastic bags, and a rubber band. If you use latex paint, rinse under running water. It helps to gently squeeze bristles with your hand or dab on the bottom of the sink until the water runs clean. A wire brush or paintbrush comb is also a helpful tool for cleaning bristles as you rinse. If you used oil-based paint, water won't do the job. You need to clean brushes and rollers with a solvent such as paint thinner. To avoid waste and environmental harm, I suggest you follow this 3-container approach. Partially fill 3 glass jars with thinner. Rinse out most of the paint in the first one. Wipe the brush with a disposable cloth or newspaper, then move to the second container and repeat the process. By the time you've immersed the paint bristles in all 3, it should be pretty clean. When you're done, pour the contents of all 3 jars into 1 and label it as used thinner. Once the paint has settled out and the thinner's clear, you can reuse it. When you're done cleaning, you can help brushes keep their shape by drying bristles with a clean rag and then wrap them tightly in plastic wrap or a piece of brown paper. Secure that with a rubber band. For storage, just hang them up. And remember, if you want to start with a good clean brush, you got to end with one too. Need more expert advice? Stop by your local True Value hardware store and ask a hardwarian. True Value. Start right. Start here.
Traveling can be stressful on its own, but by installing timer-activated lighting, you can alleviate some of the worry by giving your home the appearance you're still there. A plug-in timer for a table lamp can create the illusion of an occupied home and keep would-be intruders away. A standard wall switch can also be replaced with an in-wall digital timer that will turn interior or exterior lighting off at predetermined times or at random intervals based on your preference. Timers are an inexpensive way to provide extra security and safety and keep the electric bill down. Need more expert advice? Stop by your local True Value hardware store and ask a hardwarian. True Value. Start right. Start here.
Waterfalls are pretty, but not when they're flowing down the side of your house. Clogged gutters can cause serious damage to roof areas, as well as your home's foundation. Here's what you need to keep them clean, clear, and working properly: a ladder, work gloves, lawn bags or plastic garbage bags, a gutter scoop or trowel, a handled scrub brush, and a garden hose. First, make sure your ladder is resting on solid ground. Heavy gloves are a must. Sharp sticks, thorns, or branches can cut your fingers and hands. Now, if you don't want to scoop out leaves and debris by hand, use a tool like this. If you want more reach, opt for a long-handled gutter scoop. Toss the debris down onto the lawn below. Cover the ground with a tarp for easier cleanup. Once you've cleared out all the obstructions, use a scrub brush to clean away slime or mossy buildup. The last step is to rinse. Turn on your garden hose and run water from one end to the other. Don't forget to go back and bag the leaves and debris on your lawn. Also, be sure to trim back tree branches that hang over your house to prevent excessive buildup in the gutters below. Now you're good to go. Cleaning your gutters twice a year in the spring and fall ensures they work properly to help protect your home from water overflow and seepage. Need more expert advice? Stop by your local True Value hardware store and ask a hardwarian. True Value. Start right. Start here.
Good masking is the key to sharp professional paint lines and an overall neat finished look. And it comes in different widths for all kinds of applications. First, clean the surface and make sure it is dry and dust-free. This will help the tape stick properly. Secure the tape a few feet at a time by pressing the edge down with a putty knife. If necessary, seal the edge of the tape with the existing base color of the wall. Once the paint has dried, remove at a 45-degree angle and at a moderate speed. If adhesive sticks to the surface, try a 90-degree angle. If paint is pulling up with the tape, try scoring the edge with a razor blade before pulling further. Need more expert advice? Stop by your local True Value hardware store and ask a hardwarian. True Value. Start right. Start here.
Dimmer switches add flexibility to existing lighting. They also help you save energy and money and make your light bulbs last longer. There are several different kinds of dimmers, but today I'll be showing you how to install a three-way switch. Here's what you'll need: a dimmer switch and switch plate, standard screws, a screwdriver, a wire stripper, wire nuts as needed, and some electrical tape. Before you begin, turn off the power to the circuit you're working on at your home's main electrical panel. Then, unscrew the cover plate at the old switch and carefully pull the switch out of the box. Cut the wall wires from the existing light switch. On a three-way switch, one of the wires will be connected under a different color screw or will be plugged into a hole in the rear of the switch labeled common. Tag this wire with a piece of electrical tape. Use a wire stripper to strip off 3/8 of an inch of insulation from all wires. Install the green wire, then install the common or white wire, then install the black and red wire. Push the switch back into place, tighten the two screws that hold it in position, then install the new dimmer switch plate over the switch. Return power to the circuit and test the dimmer to make sure your installation was correctly done. And that's it. Need more expert advice? Stop by your local True Value hardware store and ask a hardwarian. True Value. Start right. Start here.
Hi, I'm Max Michelle. Welcome to the range.
Before we get started this morning, let's talk about equipment selection and equipment analysis and how you actually set up that gear.
I'm looking at a spot on the target I want to engage. Nothing's going to move. Once the buzzer goes off, I'm going to cleanly grab the pistol and bring it up to my line of sight. I'm not going to, at this point, adjust my stance while I'm drawing or duck my head down while I'm drawing. Everything's going to stay completely stable, and the only thing that's moving are my arms. All that extra motion and extra movement is going to add time to the clock, right?
Now we're looking at where we want to go. So getting the reload done as soon as possible, regardless of how much time you have, is going to be critical, right?
I'm Ben Steger. Welcome to Training to Win. We've taken over this entire range.
Stand by.
We've constructed stages, live fire drills, and dry fire drills. And our goal is to help you get better.
This video isn't just about dry fire or live fire or stage strategy. It isn't about any one of those things. It's about learning a process where you're willing to work and willing to apply yourself to get better.
From the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started
Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we'd argue every month. I was trying to get it on my own. Working all night, traffic on the way home. And my uncle calling me like, where you at? I gave you the keys, so you bring it right back. I just think it's funny how it goes. Now I'm on the road, half a million for a show. And we started from the bottom, now we're here.
Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. All the way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up.
Shorty, what you want, shorty, what you need.
What you need?
My n***s run game, we ain't never leave.
Never leave.
Counting up some money, we ain't never sleep.
Never sleep.
You got V12, I got 12 V's. Got bottles, got
I'm all the way up.
Shorty, what you want, I got what you need. Shorty, what you want, I got what you need. Shorty, what you want, I got what you need.
I'm all the way up. 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 Nothing can stop me.
Don't you open up that window. Don't you let out that antidote. It deals is how we know. Don't go through the front door. It's low key at the night show. So don't you open up that window. Don't you let out the antidote. So don't you open up that window.
Watch me clap, clap.